Today we are going to draw a cuttlefish. Cuttlefish are colloid cephalopods along with squids and octopus, so they don't have the external shell characteristic of most mollusks. As a result, these cephalopods have had to evolve different defensive tactics designed to help them evade predators, such as their texture and pattern-morphing skin. Before we draw any organism, we need to write out the classification. For this cuttlefish, we can classify down to the order Cepheida, which encompasses all cuttlefish. I will be basing my drawing off the European common cuttlefish, Cepheida officinalis, but its features will be simplified. We will be labeling the mantle, eye, feeding tentacles, arms, siphon, and fin, so make sure to pay extra attention to these body parts as we draw. Pause the video now and give the drawing a try. If you get stuck, keep watching. We start by drawing the oval-shaped mantle, which encloses the cuttlefish's organs, and the internal shell, which is called the cuttle bone. The cuttlefish's undulating fin extends laterally along the sides of the mantle. It's used for hovering and stability. The cuttlefish has a large camera-like eye with a distinctive W-shaped pupil. As we draw the arms and tentacles, we need to remember that cuttlefish have 8 arms and 2 tentacles. The tentacles have club-like ends, which they use to quickly grasp prey and then manipulate it with their arms. Unlike the feeding tentacles, which only have suckers on the ends, cuttlefish have rows of suckers along the length of their arms. Finally, the cuttlefish uses its siphon for jet propulsion by shooting water out of the mantle cavity. Now we can label the oval-shaped mantle, the camera-like eye, the 2 long feeding tentacles, the 8 shorter arms, the siphon, and the undulating fin. Now that we've finished labeling our general cuttlefish anatomy, we are going to draw a more detailed diagram of the skin layers which enable cuttlefish to change their appearance. Cuttlefish have 3 main skin layers which facilitate their color and pattern change. The first layer is the chromatophore layer. This is made up of pigment-filled sacs which can be expanded and contracted by muscle fibers to change the dominant color being displayed. The top layer of chromatophores are yellow, followed by red, and finally brown. You may be wondering how cuttlefish can produce their diverse range of skin patterning using just 3 colors. Below the chromatophores is a layer of iridophores, which are stacks of thin cells which reflect light, creating different colors and iridescence. The light reflected by these cells even appears to change color based on the angle they are viewed from. Finally, the last skin layer is the leucophore layer, found in cuttlefish and octopus, but not squids. Leucophores scatter full spectrum light, causing them to appear white. Leucophores provide the white backdrop for many cuttlefish skin patterns. Now that we've drawn all 3 skin layers, let's add some color to the chromatophores and make sure everything is labeled properly. The last element you may want to add to your skin diagram is a top view of an individual chromatophore to demonstrate the muscle fibers surrounding the pigment-filled sac.